Hello dear students, in the last video we have studied the topic of sound. Yes or no? We have studied the topic of sound. Have you revised that all the points? Yes or no? Yes, some students are saying yes, some are saying no. See, you have to revise every day some points related to the sound. Okay, so today in this video we are going to learn about the sound, how the sound is produced by a human and how the sound is detected by the ear. So in just a few seconds we will just recall what things we have learned in the sound. In the first video we have started with the introduction of the sound and how the sound is produced. So can you just tell me how the sound is produced? Yes, sound is produced by the vibration. It is very important. Vibrating object produces the sound. Yes. Yes, then we have discussed the propagation of the sound. What is meant by the propagation? The sound travels from one point to the another, that is called as a propagation of the sound. Okay, then can you tell me in which medium the sound travels very fast? In which states of matter? Yes, gases. In the state gases, the sound travels faster than solid and liquid. Then, whether the sound travels in a vacuum? No, sound does not travel in a vacuum. So, today in the video, we are going to discuss about sound produced by human. Now, see, we are all human beings, am I right? So how does the sound is produced? How my voice is detected? Can you just tell me? See, when you touch this, your throat, you can feel something vibration, am I right? If just in 1 minute, you just touch the throat. Yes, and try to speak something. Something is vibrated, am I right? So from here, the sound is produced. Now what is the actually? So you can see this diagram of the sound. Can you see this diagram of the how the sound is produced? I will explain it. Now see, this is called as a voice box. This is called as a voice box. Near your above the windpipe, this box is called as a voice box, or it is also called as a larynx. What is the another name of voice box? It is called as a larynx. Are you getting? Then there is a two vocal cords. There are the two vocal cords above the windpipe, and the lungs. The lungs forces the air, and because of the air, it pushes the air upward and the voice is produced. The voice is produced. Are you getting this? There is a voice box. You just remember that there is a voice box that is also called as a larynx. The air from when the lung forces the air through the slits of the vocal cord. It starts vibrating and produces the sound. Are you getting this? For example, now see here, what happens actually? There are the two vocals called above the windpipe. It's when lungs forces the air up, that air moves up and the vocal cord gets vibrated. And the sound is produced. Are you getting this? So this is how the sound is produced by the human. Are you getting this? Then in that, how the sound is detected by the ear? Now I am speaking to you, am I right? I am teaching you the topic, am I right? And what you people are doing? My process is I'm talking, means I am producing the sound. And what you people are doing? You are hearing. Then how do you hear? You hear with your ear, am I right? So how does the detected that we are going to learn now. Now see, this is the picture of ear. This is the picture of ear. Now see, your ear is divided into three parts: outer, middle and inner. Outer, middle and inner. At outer ear, this part is called as a pinna. What it is called? Pinna. What is the function of this pinna? It collects all the sound around you. It collects all the sound around you. And it is, now you know, canal, a dam, near there is a canal. What happens? The water is stored in the dam and through the canal it is provided to the particular villages. Yes or no? So like that, all the sound is collected in the pinna and that is passed through the canal. That is from the middle ear, that is ear canal, it is passes through the through it. Are you getting? And what after that canal, after the function of the middle ear, when the sound reaches to the eardrum starts to vibrate. The eardrum starts to vibrate and we can recognize that voice. And that voice, as the eardrum starts to vibrate, it is moved by the ordinary nerves. It is moved by the ordinary nerves and that nerves can sense the voice and you can recognize the voice. Are you getting this? Can you get this? What is actual function of the ear? See, your ear is divided into three parts: outer, middle and inner. Okay, now see, outer ear, this is called as a pinna. In that, all the sound, surrounded sound is collected. Now see, all the sound we are not in. See, there are small sound also and large sound also, right, around us. We can recognize only some sound. Are you getting? And through ear canal, all the sound is passes and eardrum starts to vibrate. And now see, my voice is loud, so you can hear my sound. Am I right? You are fully concentrated on my sound. Am I right? If, now see, around me there are also some voice of the birds. Can you hear them? No. Because my sound is very large. Means you, that only sound is detected. Are you getting? So the sound is detected by our ear. Are you getting? So this is a function of the how the sound is detected. Now we are going to learn about the sound. Whoa, just tell me, what is the sound? Sound is in the form of energy. It is a form of energy. Okay. Then these are nothing but a waves. These are nothing but, sound is nothing but, it is, they are in the form of the wave. So we are going to learn about the wave. Now we are going to learn about the waves. Now waves. Waves means, now see, you might have visited the ocean. Yes? Seashore? Yes or no? So you have seen the waves, ocean waves. Am I right? So how are the waves? The waves are like this. Yes or no? Then you might have seen the light rays, yes or no? So these are nothing but, they are in the form of the waves. Now sound, wave, these are sound when we are producing, they are in the form of the wave. Now the waves are classified into two types, that is transverse waves and longitudinal waves. They are classified into two types, transverse and longitudinal waves. Okay. Now, what are those waves? Are like this. Now you can see this. Now, what is this? Actually, the waves are in the form is this. They are vibrated. The particles of these mediums are vibrated perpendicularly. Now, this is a perpendicular. Perpendicular means 90 degree. Are you getting? The particles of the mediums are vibrated perpendicularly. Are you getting? And in the longitudinal waves, the particles of the mediums are vibrated in a parallel wave. Are you getting? So parallel means like this. Are you getting? So in the longitudinal waves, the particles of the mediums are vibrated parallelly, and in a transverse ways, the particle of the mediums are vibrated perpendicularly. Are you getting this? So these are the two types of waves. Now, although there are the different types of the waves, we are having the terms same, means both have the same terms related to the waves. The first is amplitude. Now, what is the amplitude? Amplitude is nothing but a maximum distance it reaches up or the down. Means this is the maximum distance. This is the maximum distance the reaches by the wave. This up also and down also. So this is the maximum distance reaches displacement takes by the particular wave is called as an amplitude. Now what is the wavelength? The distance between two consecutive crests or the two consecutive refraction or compression. Now here refraction means what? Here the waves are little bit separate, and in compression is the waves are compressed. Are you getting? So congested. Are you getting? So here wavelength means what? It is the distance between two crusts or two trough. The distance between two consecutive crusts or the consecutive trough. Are you getting this? So that is called as a wavelength. And wavelength is denoted by this sign. This sign is called as a lambda. That sign is called as a lambda. Are you getting this? This sign is called as a lambda. Are you getting? Then next is oscillation. Now what is meant by the oscillation? When a wave has completed one full wave. Are you getting? So that is called as a oscillation. So this, in that one crust and one trough consists of one oscillation. We can say that one oscillation is completed in this one crust and one trough. So we can say that one oscillation is completed. Then time period. Time period is nothing but time taken to complete this one oscillation. Time taken to complete this one oscillation is called a time period. Is called a time period. And it is denoted by T and it's measured in a second. We measure the time in a second. Then next is frequency. Now what is meant by the frequency? Can you tell me the number of oscillation completed in a second? Completed in a particular time, that is called as a frequency. And frequency is measured in a hertz. What is the unit of frequency? It is hertz. It is denoted by Hz. Unit of frequency is hertz and it is denoted by Hz. And this frequency is denoted by small f. It is denoted by a small f. So these are terms related to the waves. Amplitude. What is meant by the amplitude? Maximum distance by the crust or the trough is called as an amplitude. Wavelength. The distance between two consecutive crusts or the consecutive trough is called as a wavelength. Oscillation. It consists of one crust and one trough, that is called as an oscillation. The to and fro motion of the wave, to and fro motion of the wave is called as an oscillation. Time period, time taken to complete one oscillation is called as a time period. And frequency is nothing but a number of oscillation per unit time, that is called as a frequency, and it is measured in the hertz. The unit of frequency is a hertz. So I hope you have understood this. In this video we have learned about how the sound is produced by the human, how the sound is detected by our ear, and about the waves and terms. terms related to the whales. In the next video, we are going to learn about the characteristics of the whales. We are going to learn about the characteristics of the whale. Okay, thank you.